Guys, welcome back to Up Late with Charlie Ranger. Very exciting times coming straight back from that ad break. Our third ever guest is the director of the Melbourne Underground Film Festival. I've got the catalogue just here. It was on very recently, finished this Saturday past. Now, our guest is a filmmaker, film festival director, former nightclub promoter, writer, cinema critic and cultural commentator, but let's not take Wikipedia's word for it. We've got him in the studio. Richard, welcome.
Hey, mate, how are you?
Very
Your third
well.
Show, lucky number three. That's really
yeah,
good, isn't it?
Absolutely.
Yep.
Now,
that or seven is my two favourite numbers.
As soon as you sat down, you had something to show me.
I did.
What have we got rocking?
We've got the rocking the Donald Trump t-shirt, mate.
You know what Donald.
I mean? I think so, mate. I think, you know, he's not too popular, I don't think, down under. But I think, you know, he's gaining momentum in America, and I think he's a lot of fun. He's an outsider. He's a rebel, and I like that about
My
him.
Interest is, what did you pay for the shirt?
Actually, you can get them online, but yeah. I actually, there's a place on Greville Street where you can get whatever you like
yeah,
made
right.
up, the t-shirts. And I occasionally will do that, just because I like to go to film festivals. I generally wear a kind of suit, and then I wear some kind of t-shirt that's a bit upsets people at film festivals.
Donald
the Donald, he's the man yeah, at the moment for upsetting people, mate. You can have so much fun on Facebook. Just say you support Trump, even if you don't. You know what
yeah,
I mean?
It's worth
you
it.
Know, oh, it's so much fun. You can roll up all your friends. I don't know why more people aren't doing it. Everyone's like a hive mind. It's like, you know, everyone's just, oh, I agree. No, don't agree with people. Disagree. You know?
Why not?
Be dissident, even if you don't. You
know? Now, Richard. I want to ask you straight off the bat.
Sure.
What's your background in film? Where does the passion come from?
I don't know. I've been making films since I was a young boy, really. And, you know, I made Super 8 films when I was a teenager. And then when I was 21, I made my first feature with John Hewitt called Bloodlust, which was a low-budget kind of horror gangster film, which was made in 1991. There's not many other horror gangster films around, you know what I mean? And but I think we're a little bit ahead of our time. We made this film, Bloodlust, and it, you know, played at a few festivals overseas. It came out locally on VHS and everything. And then John and I continued to make films since. John made a film called Red Ball in the mid-90s. I made a film called Pearls Before Swine. And that was the film that was rejected from the Melbourne International Film Festival,
yes.
which gave me the impetus to start the Melbourne Underground Film Festival, which yes. is what I just finished number 17 of. You get less time for manslaughter, mate.
Yeah. And can you tell us a bit about how the festival went this year? Because it obviously finished just Saturday
night.
How was it? Like, did it go according to script, or was there...
We played Nathan Hill's film, Revenge of the Gwaelo, on closing night. We did the Muff Awards. And I always like to spread the awards around amongst, you know, a lot of the most talented filmmakers, because I think that's one of the main purposes of the Melbourne Underground Film Festival, is to act as a... you know, as a kind of, you know, leaping board for people's careers. I mean, we discovered James Wan, who went on to make the Saw films, and then obviously recently The Conjuring, and you know, he has a whole horror empire. I mean, the Saw horror films are the biggest horror franchise in the history of cinema. Like, it's bigger than Halloween, Friday the 13th. So, you know, it's quite good. We're the first film festival in the world to play the work of James Wan.
Yeah, right.
So, and we've got another whole bunch of filmmakers like that. Greg McLean, Patrick Hughes, who did The Expendables recently, Abe Forsyth, who did this film Down Under about the Cronulla race riots.
Yeah,
all the most happening filmmakers in Australia, for whatever reason, I don't know why, they came to
just
us
got
first.
Them.
We're
That's
the rebels.
Where they start.
We're the Donald Trump supporters, mate.
Donald Trump.
See, we just get
the
out there and do it, mate.
What about the shirts? Is that like a first prize for, you know, best film of the festival?
No, it wasn't. I just did it as a... I knew it would annoy all the left-wingers in the film industry, and I was like...
This is what I want.
I got a kind of fuck you punk attitude. Can I say that? I
well,
just did.
You know what? You haven't. It's live TV.
It
so,
is.
You know, beep, beep. Richard, I want to talk to you about the Melbourne Underground Film Festival because
yes.
we've just seen the 17th. What does the future hold? Where do you see it going? I mean, is it sort of tracking the way you expected it to when you started this thing in 2000? Or
yeah, I mean, I did it to support, you know, indie filmmakers like myself, really. I mean, obviously... I am a filmmaker, and I continue to make films. Since I made Pearls Before Swine, I made a film called The Beautiful and Dan. It was an adaptation of a novel by Scott Fitzgerald. I did that before Baz Luhrmann did his Scott Fitzgerald adaptation here.
I bet he doesn't even have a Trump shirt either.
Yeah, but he doesn't have a Trump
He'll
shirt.
He'll probably have one next
He'd have
week.
A Hillary Clinton one, that motherfucker. And I was going to say, then I did a documentary on the porn industry in Los Angeles called The Last Days of Joe Blow. I got some funding from a local producer, Jason Byrne, and I travelled the world to make that documentary. And then I decided, because I was travelling, I would make this other film called The Second Coming, which was based on the poetry of William Butler Yeats. Now, that's me being a bit pretentious. Normally, I make genre films. I'm a big advocate of genre cinema, because I think Australian cinema needs to be more... I mean, it needs to be marketable. You know, we don't want to see these, you know, polite, kitchen sink dramas that are politically correct and boring. And no one, you know, they make 10 or 20 of these films every year in Australia. No one's ever heard of them, you know.
But just on that, actually, just to interrupt you there, being an underground film festival, do you guys, do you feel pressure to you know, be putting on a certain type of work? Like, have you rejected films because you go, it doesn't fit that underground tag or that brand?
Well, we've been criticised for broadening the definition of underground. This prick of a local film critic by the name of Adrian Martin, who actually attacked me on Facebook just the other day. I thought, 17 years later, he's still not a nice person. We'll say that. I'm like Donald Trump, I got a big mouth. And basically, underground used to mean people like Jonas Mekas, Kenneth Anger, people who made very arty films that were literally for the underground. But I mean, the way I saw that underground cinema had also included like low budget genre filmmaking and like micro budget cinema, things like no wave cinema, you know, just people basically picking up a camera and going and making cinema. Now, sometimes, you know, the results are terrible, and obviously we don't play that. Occasionally we do, because you know, we just sometimes just support people because we like the filmmaker or something. But occasionally someone picks up a camera who's an absolute genius.
Yeah.
And you think this person is incredible.
If you do find that diamond in the rough and
well, yeah, you know, I mean, there's a couple of filmmakers that have yet to, you know, make it to the stage of, say, someone like James Wan. I mean, Addison Heath is one I can really recommend to people. He made the opening night film, The Perfect Nonsense. And Stuart Simpson is another filmmaker we've been playing all his work. And Daniel Armstrong has got this film called Cheburg Massacre. There's a whole kind of army of these, there's definitely a group who want to make interesting genre films. And I think if we just got a little bit of support, what I would suggest is, like, you know, Film Victoria or Screen Australia, just put 100 grand. We don't need millions. 100 grand per filmmaker. So and you'd have a new Mad Max every year. You'd have a film as good as new Mad Max. You'd have a new Peter Jackson. You'd have a new Quentin Tarantino. You'd have a new, coming out of this country, we would have the most dynamic film industry in the world, I think. We have such amazing talent here.
So do you find at the moment then that these films are getting seen by the same audience? Like, do you find it's an issue in terms of finding a broad enough audience or...?
Well, the hardest thing with independent filmmaking is obviously it's hard to do it, I mean, and then to actually produce a quality piece of work. But once you've done that, and most people who can do that, you know, then is getting it seen. You know, that's the hardest thing.
Yeah.
Well, obviously, if you make something that's the genius and no one sees it, well, you know, you're a bit like Vincent van Gogh, not yet to sell your first painting kind of thing. But like, if it wins a major award at MUF, it'll get into another film festival from that.
Yeah.
You know, it'll get into, and then from there we'll go, you know. And if you're aggressive enough online and send it out, it could end up playing, I mean, Andrew Leovold's recent film, he played at about 80 film festivals, including MUF, around the world. And he travelled for about a year with that film, you know, his Weng Weng film.
Something I'm really interested in is, obviously, this is a project you've built from the ground up from 2000 to 2016.
Yeah, well, I used to run the Hellfire Club. Did you ever hear that?
The
Hellfire Club before that.
No, I have not heard of the Hellfire
Club. That was
very,
just near here over in Queensbury Street, that was a very kinky nightclub, S&M, that kind of thing, from like the early 90s, yeah.
Were there any films made at the Hellfire Club in the early days?
Mark Mikaitis, one of the MUF filmmakers, made a film about Hellfire. He interviewed me and a lot of people who used to go to it, and so that's actually on the DVD to Last Days of Joe Blow that you can get from Monster Pictures. Just go to the Monster Pictures website, put in Last Days of Joe Blow, and you can get my new film and also the documentary about the Hellfire Club. We just thought we'd include it because it's sort of connected, really, in a way. And but yeah, I guess I realised that next year I will have been running, different events in Melbourne for 25 years. You know what I mean?
So are there any plans to maybe hand the reins over to someone else soon? Or
I think people might like that. Basically, MUF is it's a small festival. You know what I mean? It's run on the catering budget of like the opening night of the Melbourne International Film Festival, and yet we've discovered it. Just about every important filmmaker this country that's come out of this country the last 15 years. And the million-dollar budget at MIF hasn't. How's it even technically possible? I don't know. But it's just that we accept people and we like something that's a bit different. And we have a kind of rebel spirit and, you know, a bit of an FU attitude to the establishment. And I think that's healthy. And I don't know. I think you're stuck with me because if I decided not to do it, it wouldn't happen, basically. So,
what's up?
I don't have an infrastructure.
Next? What's next? Now that you've just finished the festival for this year?
I'm making a new film. I'm shooting a new film in late October. I'm going to start shooting a new feature. It's back. I did the Second Coming, Volume 1 and 2. It's a bit Terrence Malick, it's a bit Kenneth Anger, it's a bit David Lynch, maybe, I don't know. So it's a bit more pretentious for me, and I'm going to go back to making a real balls to the wall, shocking genre feature. Fantastic. Disturbing. That's what I'm doing.
Richard, it's crazy how little time we have because I feel like we've only just started scratching the surface. But we want to say thank you so much for coming on the show tonight. And guys, Melbourne Underground Film Festival, it'll be there again next year.
We'll be back.
Richard, you're not going
number
anywhere,
18.
It doesn't sound like.
All right, mate.
Thank you so much. Guys,
lucky
we're back
number 3.
After this break with Alex Elbury and The Strangers.